Hello and welcome to Homegrown. My name is Kirsten Lipkins and I'm the Education Director for the Springfield Symphony. And I am so happy and excited today to have three members of the Storytime Quintet. And these three members are incredible musicians and members of the Springfield Symphony Orchestra. We have Ann Bobo, who is our principal flautist, Lauren Winter, our principal horn player, and Grace Shryock, our English horn player, who I am a very big fan of because I play oboe. Welcome everyone, and thank you for being here today and for sharing your video. Ann, tell me what this video is of today that we will be listening to.
Oh, it's a special little holiday treat that we put together for everybody. It is a woodwind quintet version of Sleigh Ride with some little extras thrown in.
We'll keep it a surprise, right, for everyone to watch. But I want all of our Homegrown audience to know that this is wonderful for all ages, but do get your kids to come and watch. And Lauren, how did you put this together? Because you did not all get together in the same room, did you?
No, so we start out with individual click tracks on an app called Acapella that we have a tempo set and we record it in chunks and then send it as a collaboration. So we all kind of record on top of each other and that's just the audio. And then our amazing leader, Grace, does the editing master. She's the editing mastermind and puts it all together. And then we do like a video recording. So it's just mostly for like looks, making sure you have a better background, better lighting, but not necessarily for sound. So we have two audio and video, and then she lays them on top of each other and makes it look amazing.
That is incredible. Grace, how long does it take you to make these videos?
This one was not so long because it is a shorter piece, but so this one took probably 4 hours or so to edit the music and the video together. But when we also have done other programs like Peter and the Wolf and stuff, and Peter and the Wolf was quite an endeavor because it's a long piece, it's a 23 minute piece. Mm-hmm. And so we had to record it in about, I don't know, probably 40 separate chunks, including 40 separate video takes, so that we could edit it together. So that one was a longer process, but it gives me something to do when we're stuck in our little bubbles. So
it does. And this quintet, did you, it called Storytime Quintet, did it just come together when the quarantine started, or have you been together as a group for a while, Anne? And tell us about your other two members.
So yeah, I'll answer part of that question. And I apologize if you can hear noise in the background. My daughter is having her band class via Zoom in the next room. So if you hear any extra music, that's what's going on. We actually started playing together last year, and this has been Grace's I don't know what to say. You've been the mastermind behind all of it. We started together last year doing live performances in mostly preschools so far. And I actually feel like Grace would be better to answer it since it was your idea from the beginning. But we did start actually in person last year.
That's so great. Grace, tell us, about the birth of the Storytime Quintet.
So this is something I've actually wanted to do for a long time. Like since I was in grad school, I had always wanted to put together some type of little education program for kids, because I feel like so often young kids are kind of forgotten when it comes to high quality music performances. And the way that I thought we could engage them was by mixing together classical music with stories so that kids would really get their imaginations going, and they would just be more engaged and more interested rather than just listening to just the music. And so what we did is we started with Peter and the Wolf at preschools, and I have a 2-year-old, so I'm kind of tuned into that age right now. So we started doing Peter and the Wolf at preschools, and we started in January doing our performances, and we had a bunch lined up for the rest of the year, and then March came and we had to shut everything down. And so when it looked like this was still going to be happening during the school year, we decided we wanted to try to take it virtual so that we could provide something for teachers to use. And so we've actually upped the age that we perform for now. And we do a lot for elementary and middle school kids as well. And we've put together these full units with Peter and the Wolf and Ferdinand the Bull. And we're working on a new one for the Tortoise and the Hare that will come out in January. And we have a bunch of activities and stuff that goes along with it. And so then teachers can use it with their students while they're in person or virtual or having to do both at the same time. And it's been a really fun project, and it's been interesting actually, even though we can't be in person with the kids, so that we're missing a little bit of that connection, we actually have been able to reach a much wider audience because we're not limited to where we can drive. We have people using this in the UK and in Australia and like all over the United States. And it's just been really interesting to see the sort of connections we can make virtually with all of these students right now. So it's been actually a really strangely connecting experience.
That is so wonderful. Well, I know that we'll have lots of information on our website about this and on Facebook with links to how people can access your videos and learn more about your quintet. Hey, this is the Zoom world. Things fall over.
The microphone fell off the stand.
Not a problem, as long as it's your oboe, okay? But then finally, Lauren, would you tell us a little bit about this particular video, Sleigh Ride? You are undertaking a fundraiser, and so we would also like to have our patrons hear about this.
Absolutely. Well, I think we actually skipped over talking about the other two.
Yes, members. Do that as so well.
I'll talk about that. And then Grace, if you want to talk about the fundraiser, since sure. You have been doing all of the research behind that. And so our other two members are Stephanie Busby and Ronnie Moore. And they are both amazing. Stephanie Busby is our bassoonist and Ronnie Moore is our clarinetist. They're both amazing freelance musicians around the Boston area that when Grace had approached me about like, hey, would you be interested in doing something like this? And by the way, do you have any recommendations for clarinet and bassoon? And I was like, well, you know, and of course in December, not this year, but we do a million nutcrackers at the Boston Ballet. So I was seeing Stephanie and Ronnie all the time. And I just know that I know they're playing. I know they're amazing. And of course, to have like an all-female woodwind quintet was very cool. And so I asked both of them, and I was like, "Would you guys be interested in doing something like this?" And they're like, "Yeah, that would be amazing." So that is how that kind of came to be. And we love that it kind of is like it. Not that we market it that way, but it kind of is just like this all-female powerhouse woodwind quintet group, which is amazing. So yeah, then the fundraiser, I guess, Grace.
Love it. Yeah. Tell us about this fundraiser.
So we are holding our first annual holiday fundraiser, and we're doing it on behalf of Feeding America. And we chose Feeding America for a lot of reasons, but they just do amazing work. Right now with COVID-19, they estimate that there will be 54 million people facing hunger, and because so many people have lost their jobs, and that includes 18 million children. And we wanted to do something that could affect a lot of these families that are really struggling right now. Every $1 that is donated can provide at least 10 meals to a family in need. And currently our fundraiser has raised $450, which is more than enough to feed a family of four for a year. And that's just amazing. And I hope that we can keep it going and really get food to a lot of food insecure people right now.
Thank you for doing that and for telling us about Feeding America. I'm going to give right after we sign off. So it's an amazing organization. And so thank you everybody for coming today and telling us about the Storytime Quintet. And now let's enjoy Sleigh Ride.
Thank you.
Have a great day.
Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.